I've been in so many interviews just sitting on the floor in my mom's office. I learned how to interview, what questions would be asked, and the best responses. And so that really helped me, because everyone in my family crapped out at the same time. Like, if you met my family now, you'd think, oh, she grew up with a silver spoon in her mouth. But I actually was a pregnant homeless teen. I lived in a shelter when I had a shelter. Sometimes I didn't. Sometimes I was lucky and had a tent or a car I could sleep in. And I managed to go to University of Miami and make it through that, get a bachelor's in business. And the only reason I don't think I succumbed to like drugs and alcohol or someone like Jeff Epstein, which are all, they have people like that prowl the streets in Southern Florida, is because I had a presence about me that I learned from my mother, and I knew what to say and I knew what jobs to get. And I was able to just to be different than the people around me. Also, I worked very hard on my accent. I come from Texas. I actually have a natural Texas accent. And I spoke to a woman at the shelter, and she was like, you're going to have to work on that. And I thought about it, and she was African-American. She was actually originally from Haiti, and her family had immigrated to Miami. And she had the most beautiful speaking voice I ever heard. And I remember thinking she was so professional. She just sounded like she just walked out of the halls of Harvard. And so I remember thinking, yeah, that's the greatest. If you take off everyone's clothes, how they speak and how they act, that tells you a lot about who they are. It also transcends class, gender, race. And so we have a unique ability here in America that if you can learn the accent, the language of business, the uniform of business, it'll open up doors all over the world. Any country you can go to, you are perceived as a business person. It's like a universal passport to anything. It's very powerful, and I hate the fact that we have entire people trying to degrade that now, because that really can break people out of, like me, being homeless. When you learn that skill, it's quite different. And I've seen people learn that skill that are every gender or orientation and race, and they've managed to be very successful compared to the people who don't do that. So I know it works. Anyway, so I got out of it, went into sales, marketing, HR, because that's what my mom did, and I kind of learned that from osmosis. And I ended up in a 25-year career doing crisis intervention for businesses. Didn't start out like that. It started out really with terrible employers. I was hired for one thing. I just worked really hard. I kept on taking extra jobs, and then they'd want to downsize and just see how much they could load that little girl up. That's really how it started. So I learned accounting, and I learned sales, and I learned whatever I needed to learn, because you have to be scrappy when you don't have a pot to pee in. And I also learned about real estate, became an investor. And then about a decade ago, my specialty morphed into running virtual organizations, which is now, everybody's talking about it now because COVID is a big thing, but I've been doing that for a decade. Expanding companies like this, it's the workplace of the future. We don't need to be clogging our roadways, adding to emissions for the majority of jobs. We have everything we need with the internet now to educate our children at home, protect them, work from home, and to do everything that we need, really. But we're not utilizing it. It's like we have the greatest resource, and we're just wanting to, you know, look at cat videos and gripe about politics, which is a little bit annoying. But anyway.
To listen to the full episode, head on over to nfacoaching.com, hit the podcast link, and it'll take you to all of the full episodes. And go ahead and leave some comments. I'd love to hear from you to know how these inspirational interviews, tips, and tools are impacting you in your life and business. And be sure to hit that subscribe button so you never miss out on any of the Max Potential Habits episodes.